Hi, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can apply and remove validators to certain form controls dynamically depending on the values from other form controls in your Angular form. I will show you how to do that using reactive forms, and you will see which pitfalls you might encounter during the implementation of this feature. And of course, I will show you how you can overcome them. If it is your first time on my channel, my name is Dmytro Mrzanski, and my goal is to help you to become an advanced Angular developer who develops applications consciously, knowing what you are doing and why. In the past, I covered quite a lot of advanced Angular topics in depth, so you can check them out later on my channel. But now let's focus on dynamic validators in our Angular web forms. Sometimes it happens that we should disable or enable some validator depending on certain conditions. In our case, we might have a requirement like we should make passport data required for those who are older than 18 years old. So depending on what the user chooses in select, we should make this field either required or not. So how would we do that? Well, to achieve this, we have to do a couple of steps. First, we have to subscribe to value changes in the year of birth form control. And the second step is, depending on the values from it, we should add or remove the required validator to password form control and update its validity state. Let's get started with the first step. To listen for the form control changes in reactive forms, you have to get a reference to the control you want to listen to and access the value changes property. It is an observable, so you can subscribe to it and get the new values from form control here. We can create a helper function here somewhere, I don't know, here below, that will be taking the user's year of birth that was selected. And depending on that, it will return true if the user is an adult or false otherwise. So pretty simple one. Now we can use this method inside the subscribe callback and do a simple check. If the user is an adult, then we should add a new validator. To add the validator to some certain control, we can use the addValidators method and provide the validator function as an argument, or you can provide an array of validator functions. That's it. Then, if the user is not an adult, we need to remove the validator, and you can do this by calling the method removeValidator and providing the validator you are going to remove. Looks good, but we are not ready yet. However, let's go and check what we currently have. So I pick the year of birth that makes the user an adult, and you can see that passport control becomes invalid, which proves that the required validator has been added. And when I pick another year of birth that makes the user a child, the passport field becomes valid because the required validator has been removed. However, you probably noticed that to update the validity for the passport control, I have to enter anything into the field to trigger validation running. It is not good UX, so let's fix it. To trigger validations manually for the form control or form group, you have to call a corresponding method called updateValue and validity. Just make sure that you call it after you added or removed validators. Now we can go back and try to do the same actions one more time. And you can see that the status is being switched automatically without the need to enter the value into the passport field every time to manually trigger validators. But still, it is not yet the solution. The problem here is that the red or green border appears only for dirty control, so I have to make the passport control dirty manually to see the border, right? But it would be way better to do that automatically. So when the user selects a new year of birth, I mark the passport control automatically dirty, right? So Let's get back to the code and implement that. You can do it right inside the subscribe callback or use the tab or XGS operator, but for now, let's do it inside the subscriber callback if you don't mind. In a minute, we'll refactor it anyway. And here I just call a method mark as dirty that will eventually mark the passport control dirty. Now, if we save changes and check them one more time, you can see that the appropriate border appears automatically when I switch the year of birth. It kind of works so far, but here's another problem. When we reload the page and fill out all required fields like that, and also we have to enter password. Here we go. Now you can see that the form is considered to be valid even though we have an adult user, which means that the passport number has to be a required field. This problem happens because we add or remove the validator only when year of birth control emits some value, which doesn't happen immediately, right? So to emit value immediately into the stream, we can use the RxJS operator called startWith and use the initial form control value as a start value. It will solve the issue, but it will also immediately mark the passport form control as dirty, which is not good, right? So that's why I will go back and move the code responsible for marking passport control as dirty. I will move it into the separate tab operator that I'm going to add. And by the way, make sure that you add it before the start with, because otherwise you will get the same result actually. And this is pretty much it. In such a way, validators will be added or removed immediately and every time the new values come. When the mark as dirty will be called only when new values come from the year of birth control. And now, if I go back, you can see that if I fill out the form again and leave the passport field empty, the form gets invalid because the required validator has been added immediately. But when I provide some valid data for the passport field, in this case, the form becomes valid. Cool. But before I end this video, I would like to mention about one important thing you should keep in mind. When Angular removes validators, it uses references. So validators like required, email, etc., they have the same reference. But if you would try to use a validator that takes a parameter, like for instance, min length, it won't work because those functions have different pointers in the memory, and that's why this validator cannot be removed. In that case, you would need to use something like property or anything else to store the reference to the validator function and use this property for add validators and remove validator methods. Only then it will work, so keep in mind that. And this is basically it regarding this topic. During the remaining minute or so, I will just complete the stream when the component is being destroyed and add some error message for the passport field. Let's solve the unsubscription issue first. So you can use any strategy you like for that, but I will be using the simplest one and unsubscribe from the stream inside the ng on destroy lifecycle hook. So for that, I have to implement an appropriate interface called onDestroy, and of course, I have to create a corresponding ng onDestroy method where I will be doing unsubscribing actually. But before, we would need to create a property for our subscription, right? So let's go up and call it like, I don't know, hvalidators. And it's going to be a subscription type. Then I have to assign the stream to this property in the onInit lifecycle hook. Okay, and then I can unsubscribe from it inside the onDestroy lifecycle hook. Good, it is done. And now we will go to the template, and I'm going to add the error message also to the passport number. So I will just duplicate this error message, but this time I check if there is an error for the required validator. And of course, I have to change the error message right here. And here we go. Now, if we check it in the browser, you can see that when I make the user adult, the passport field turns invalid. And you can also see the corresponding error message that tells the user what exactly is wrong with this field. Now let's quickly recap what we just learned. To add or remove a validator to some certain control, you can call the addValidators or removeValidators method accordingly and provide the validator function you want to apply, or an array of validators. To immediately apply the newly added validator, you have to call the method updateValueAndValidity and make sure that the reference to validator in removeValidator method is the same as the one in addValidators method. Otherwise, you might get inappropriately working validation. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this lesson, which is just a tiny part of my entire video course dedicated to Angular Forms, and this is more than 120 lessons and 14 hours of video content dedicated to Angular Forms, and there we dive really in depth to this topic. We even explore the source code of Angular Forms in order to figure out how everything is working and what is the most efficient way to build some certain stuff. Besides that, we will create from scratch quite a lot of exciting components and architectural decisions. For example, using only Angular CDK, we will build from scratch such a complex drop-down component where you can filter out options, you can navigate through these options using your keyboard, and this drop-down will support multi-selections. Besides that, you will learn how to create forms dynamically from some JSON config, and also you will see how to manage your validation error messages dynamically without creating a lot of boilerplate in your Angular component templates. These and many other things related to Angular Forms you will learn from the course. Link will be in the video description. Otherwise, thanks for watching this video until the end. Please share this video if you find it useful, and don't forget to leave your thoughts and subscribe to my channel. This everything motivates me to create even more content about Angular. And I wish you a productive week ahead, guys. Stay safe and see you in the next lesson.